Hello everyone, this is a basic workflow demo for the Greeble Bake add-on. So basically what this add-on aims to do is to make it easier to generate texture map details from geometry using by default a primitive plane as a canvas. Anything you design on this canvas or put on top of it will be baked, and this baking process is only limited to the z-axis or any details that goes up or down if we consider the z-axis to represent these directions. We can bake patterns, normal stencils, and Greeble details, and put them in a material shader to provide texture details to a particular model. The rest of the bake types will bake from geometry, except for color, which bakes from a colored pass, and emit, which bakes from emission or the emission shader. Without a bake to object set, the script will create its own bake to object, which is also a primitive plane that is controlled using the size and offset property and is removed automatically once the baking process is over. Size being its scale, and offset is how far it is from the bake origin object. With conform shape enabled, this bake to plane is going to copy the x and y dimension of the bake origin object but will disregard the size property. The disadvantage, however, is that you cannot edit the default UV unwrap used to bake the texture maps. This is where the bake to object property comes in. This search bar will show you all the unselected objects, which is the reverse of the bake origin object property above it, and will let you pick the bake to object from that list that will replace the bake to plane created by the script. This is great if you want to control the UV unwrap of the bake to object. Now let's go to the bake origin object. The reason why the optimal object or canvas for this is the primitive plane is that its origin point is in the middle of its flat geometry. This origin point is used as a zero threshold where the texture color is black, meaning no displacement, and anything higher than this will contain the depth color information. You can modify this depth color information using the distance, brightness, and contrast properties. If you have geometry you wish to bake as displacement but is under the origin point, then just lower the distance value until you get the right position to include these details. You can also initially set the bake origin object lower to include these details in the depth texture map bake. The redo panel can also help you set this up by pressing the F9 hotkey to execute the same baking action with new settings. Enable the bake to last images toggle, then use a lower map resolution like 256 or 512 pixels and only bake the depth map until you get the right values. When you have them, then you can bake the rest of the maps in your desired resolution. Lastly, we have the exclude bake origin toggle. This will remove or exclude the bake origin object from the bake process and just use it to position the bake to plane and also establish the zero depth threshold. If you are using a bake to object, this will only work for setting the zero depth threshold for the displacement. And that is it for this video, which is a short overview of the basic workflow using the add-on. If you have any questions, use the comment section or the links in the description. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.